Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today's topic is the public health topic in which we are going to cover the statistics. So today's topic is the biostatistics. So without further ado, let's get started. So guys, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future videos. So talking about the chi-square test in biostatistics. So well, in order to understand the chi-square test, let me give you a circumstance, a situation. Well, if I have to count the comments, good comments, nice comments, as well as if I want to see the critics' comments in my videos. So I'm not going to count each and every comment. So well, in that case, I'm going to take only 20 comments and I'm going to check the ratio of 20 comments. Now, what I am expecting is that the ratio is going to be 19:1. So 19 out of 20 comments, 19 are going to be the good comments. But this is what I feel that. This is not the truth. So I feel that my videos are good and I am getting good comments. I will get good comments and see, I'll get at least minimum of 19 good comments. One can be a critic comment. So that is what I am expecting, right? But when I do the analysis, then out of 28 comments are only good. 12 comments are bad. So in that case, well, you know that my videos are not good, right? And I know that it isn't true. I need to improve a lot. So I just can't go with a gut feeling. I need to go for the realization, for the reality. I need to open my eyes and see the reality. And here comes the chi-square test, which is going to open my eyes, which is going to tell me that what is right, what is wrong, right? So chi-square test, how do we do this test? So basically, I'm going to just make a table for this. So suppose if I want to see the good comments, how many are good, how many are bad. Right, now I have here the observation. This is the observation, what I observed. This is the expectations, what I expected. So what I expected was out of 20, 19 are going to be the good comment and one is going to be a bad comment. This is what I was expecting. But what was reality? What I observed? What I observed was that only 8 comments out of 20 were good and 12 comments were bad comments. So I'm going to see, always we start from the null hypothesis. So null hypothesis states that there is no relationship, right? So the both the comments are going to be equal in number. That was the null hypothesis. But we are ultimately, if the null hypothesis is get rejected, that means our thesis or our research is working going well. So we come to the alternate hypothesis. So according to that, chi square, the formula for chi square, this is why, see, this is the square root. So the square root of chi is the formula. So this is the constant. Then we have frequency of observed. That means number of the observed. So frequency of observed is going to be, we have to write this table, then we have to write frequency of expected, then is going to be the frequency divided by frequency of expected. So this, once we come to know, we have a value of the chi square, right? So once we have the value of chi square, like how we talked about in the student t-test, like that, after we get the value, we have to compare it in the table. Now in the table one side, we have again, like the table of student t-test, we have a table of chi-square test. In that, this side is going to be the degree of freedom. So what is the degree of freedom? Degree of freedom is the freedom which is given to the number, right? So suppose if I have done on 20, right? So this is going to be my number of frequency, we can say. But the degree of freedom is, see, out of 20, 19 are going to get the freedom, right? Either it can be good or bad, but last one will not get the choice. So that is our degree of freedom, which is n minus 1. We have already spoke about this degree of freedom in the student t-test also, last video. So this is our degree of freedom. This side is going to be the probability. The probability level, the P level. That also we have talked about in the previous video. So probability, we take it 0.05. That is 5% will be the probability. So that is we take for a research, for a thesis, to be the relationship between the two variables. If the difference is this much, then we can say that two variables are related to each other. If difference is at least more than this, if difference is less than that, then we can say both variables are same only. There is not much of difference. At least this much of difference should be there. So according to the degree of frequency, we check the values and then we say, we come to this chi-square test. We come to this conclusion that either the things are related, either the variables are associated, or we say that if the value is more less than P, then we say that they are not associated, variables are not associated. So we had two types of chi-square test. One is the test of independence. So test of independence means when the two variables we have and we have to check the association among the two variables. So that is, it tells the us the independence level, right? So it is the test of independence. Second one we have is the goodness of fit. So goodness of fit is when we have only one variable, right? And we are expecting it with our, comparing it with the expected observation. So suppose we have something, some expectation. Suppose goodness of fit example I can give. Suppose if I am expecting I will score 70% in my exams. That is, and if I score only 56%. So that is comparing this level with the expected one. Now you are, since you are studying, you are watching the videos, definitely you are going to score close to the expectations, not so much less. So this one, when we are comparing with the expected observation, then that is the goodness of the fit. There is only one variable, right? So like this. So there are two kinds, the test of independence, the goodness of test. Now this is goodness of fit. This is usually done. The chi-square test is usually done for the nominal or ordinal data. Now you can see nominal or ordinal data we have already covered in the biostatistics. Now nominal is when there are two variables which are almost equal, right? Like it can be pass-fail. It can be good-bad. Male-female, right? Or it can be heads-tail. It can be male, female, like that we have is the normal. Ordinal data is when there is an order, like class 1, vocation area, suppose we are talking class 2, class 3, class 4, like that we have orders. Fair, poor, suppose if you are talking about the oral hygiene status, so it can be, it will go from the least is the poor, then it will go from the fair, like that, good. Like this, we will go in order. So that will be our ordinal data. So chi-square test is usually done because we have something to compare with the expectations. So it is usually done with the nominal or ordinal data. When we have this nominal or ordinal data, we do chi-square test. But in order to do the chi-square test, we must have assumption or expectations, right? We must have a value of expectation. We must have the frequency. Frequency is number of the time something is happening, like good comments. Number of time the comments, I am seeing the good comments. So that is the counts basically we can say. So this must be expressed in terms of frequency, that it is going to be, how many times it is going to be good, how many times it is going to be bad, how many times head will come, how many times tail will come, how many males are there, how many females are there, like that. There is a number. So number of times, or we can say it should be expressed in a count, and therefore it can be actually used to examine the differences between the frequency in the sample. As you can see, there is a differences between the frequency in the sample in the formula itself. So this is about the chi-square test. I hope that you guys are clear with the chi-square test. There are two types of chi-square test. This is usually asked a 2-marker question in case of public health dentistry. Not much. So guys, this is, and mostly you do it for nominal or ordinal data. So guys, this is about the chi-square test, and I hope that you guys are clear with the chi-square test. And if you have enjoyed watching the video, then give it a thumbs up. And also you can comment in the comment section below. And guys, now you have a chance in the description box below. You can support me on Paytm as well as on PayPal if you want to get more interesting free videos like this and also free notes for you. So guys, take care, tata, bye bye, keep studying, keep reading. I will see you soon in the next video.